Hello, I wanted to share a few tips about the TI-36X Pro, which will just make your life a little easier when you're doing some of your calculations. For exponents, there's two different ways to do an exponent. So if you're taking something to the second power, then the button right next to the 7 is what you want. So if you want to take 5 to the second power, you're going to hit 5, and then that x squared button. And that's going to automatically take that to the second power, and then you're going to hit enter. So that would be 25. If you want to take something to the third power, then you can use the button above that. And that has an X with a little empty box. And that just means you can put whatever you want in that. So I'm going to hit 5, and then I'm going to hit that button. Whoop, I didn't hit that button. I hit the one above it, below it. So now I hit the 5 with the box, and then it's blinking and saying, well, what power are you interested in? And then I hit the 3. So 5 to the third power is 125. And if you want to take negative 5 to the third power, that's different because you have to tell the calculator that it's negative 5 the entire quantity to the power. So we can come over here and put parentheses, that's just above the 8, and then hit the negative button. And the negative button is down here at the bottom, not the subtraction button, but the negative. So we have negative 5, and then close the parentheses, and then hit that power button again. And tell this now we want this to go to the third power, and that would give us negative 125. And I could have used an even power and maybe demonstrated that a little nicer, but it works either way. So that's the power button. The fraction button is right above this 7, and you can do a lot with the fraction button. 2/3 plus 1/5. There's two different ways I could do this. I could hit the 2 and then hit that fraction button and put that into the that makes it a fraction, and then I could do the thirds. And then to get out of that, I'm going to use my arrow to the right, and now I'm going to add, and now I'm going to do it the other way, 1/5. I'm going to go ahead and start with my fraction button, and by hitting that first and then hit the 1, use the down arrow to get down to the 5, and I can just hit enter there, but it might be a good habit to take the arrow and get out of that, and then just hit enter, and it's going to give you 13/15. Now, if you want to change to a decimal, I'll show you how to do that in a minute. The second one, we're going to do a mixed number, and the mixed number is directly above the 7. You can see one large box and then two smaller boxes here. So that's what the mixed number looks like. They have a bar in between. And so I'm going to get to that by hitting second function. So if I want to enter 1 3/4, I can go second function and then hit that button, and that gives me the 3 parts. So I'm going to have 1, and I'm going to arrow over. It's going to go to the numerator, 3, arrow down to the 4th, arrow out of that. Now I'm going to add, and I'm going to do this again, 2, arrow over 1/3. Again, arrow to get out of it. So these arrows left and right, up and down, help you move around. So I have 1 3/4 plus 2 1/3, and that is 49/12. If you want to know what 49/12 is as a mixed number, you can go to math, the math button, and you see the number 1 says change from, it shows you an improper fraction and a mixed. Hit enter, and that's going to say, okay, we're going to take that last answer and change it for you, and it'll change it into your mixed number, which was 4 1/12. So I'll do that again. Let's say I have 1 3/4. So I have 1 3/4, but I want to know what is that as a improper fraction. So I'm going to hit math, and then the very first choice is that changing. So I'm going to hit enter, enter again, and I get 7/4. All right, that's using that math button. Now what if I want to take 7/4 and find out what that is as a decimal? Well, this is the button down here. It's the second from the bottom. It's on the calculator, 2 from the bottom, that is fraction to decimal. And so I'm going to hit second function, fraction to decimal. And it changes it either from a decimal to a fraction or back and forth. Fraction to a decimal, hit enter, is 1.75 for our answer. So 3/4 as a, from a fraction to a decimal, is 0.75. All right, you can find the least common multiple of two numbers. Let's say I want to know the least common multiple of 25 and 30. Remember, that's saying what's the first number that 25 and 30 will both go into. So to get to that, you're going to go to math and then go to number 2. So I'm just going to use my arrow to go down, or I could have hit the number 2 and then hit enter, and it's going to say, okay, you want to find the least common multiple, what numbers? So I'm going to enter 25, and then I'm going to enter the comma, which is above the decimal point down here. So second function, comma, and then the 30. And I can close the parentheses. I don't think I actually have to on this calculator, but it's good practice. And then hit enter, and that's going to tell you that 150 is the first number they would both go into. What if you wanted to know the greatest common factor? They have GCD, but the greatest common factor of these two numbers, and that is asking what's the greatest number that goes into both of those. Well, that would be math down to 3, and then again, I would say 25, second function, comma, 30, and that one would tell me 5, and that tells me that the GCD for 25 and 30, or GCF is what we would call it, is 5. That's the greatest number they have in common. And one last thing I want to show you is the answer button and how you don't have to keep entering and re-entering things. So on this one I have, what if I started off with 15 divided by 0.04? That gives me 375. And then I start my next problem, 17. Oh, I want to add that last thing that I had. So I'm going to say plus, and then I'm just going to see this button down here that says answer. I'm going to hit second function, answer, and what that's saying is that we're adding that last answer on. Now if I enter that, I get 392. Then I have 12, and oh, now I want to divide 12 by 392. Again, I'm going to say divided by second function and answer. And that's going to divide 12 by 392 and give me an answer. So I don't have to go back and enter those answers again. If it's the last thing, I can just use that answer button. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.